47th session, unit 5, electrical instruments and measurements. In this session, we'll determine the expression for horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field, vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, and angle of depth. The learning objectives of this session will be, first learning objective is to determine horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field, that is BH, and vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, that is BB. Second objective is to determine the angle of dip, that is psi. To determine the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field, we have the circuit diagram, and in the circuit diagram you can see the ballistic galvanometer is connected on top, and across the ballistic galvanometer we have connected a tapping key which is used for charging and discharging. One end of the ballistic galvanometer is connected to the earth conductor, and other end of that earth conductor is connected to the secondary coil, then to primary coil, then that primary coil is connected to one of the commutator keys. From the commutator key, it is connected to negative end of the ammeter, and the positive end of the ammeter is connected to positive of the battery, and the negative end of the battery is connected to the lower end of the rheostat, and the upper end is connected back to the commutator key, and from commutator key it is given to the primary coil and then to secondary coil, and then that secondary coil is connected to ballistic galvanometer. Now the procedure to find out the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Firstly, the coil is set with its axis of rotation vertical, and the plane of the coil is set to east-west direction, that is perpendicular to the magnetic meridian. Secondly, the coil is now rapidly rotated through 180 degrees by a spring key. After setting the coil to east-west direction and then rotating it through 180 degrees, the induced charge due to change in flux through the ballistic galvanometer, which gives a deflection theta h, then from equation 1 of 46th session, we have 2n into h into a upon r. So in that expression, only H is replaced by B. Here we have taken magnetic field as H. So in place of B, I have written H. Therefore, 2nHa upon R is equal to K times theta H into bracket 1 plus lambda upon 2. So let this equation be 2, where capital R is the total resistance, and n is the number of turns of the coil, and capital H is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. The flux linked to the secondary coil will change by amount given by, that is mu naught into Np, where Np is the total number of turns of primary coil, Ns total number of turns of secondary coil, As the area of the secondary coil, into I minus into bracket minus mu naught Np Ns As into I bracket complete is equal to 2 times mu naught Np into Ns into As into I. The charge due to the change in flux is given as Q is equal to 2 times mu naught into Np into Ns into As into I upon R. If theta is the ballistic throw, when this charge passes through ballistic galvanometer, then it is given by 2 mu naught into Np into Ns into As into I upon R is equal to K theta into bracket 1 plus lambda by 2. So let this equation be 3. Now dividing equation 2 by equation 3, we have N into A into H upon mu naught into Np into Ns into As into I is equal to theta H upon theta. Hence the expression for H, can be obtained by transferring all the terms of left hand side except the h onto the right hand side. We have capital H is equal to mu naught into np into ns into as upon n into a into theta h upon theta. So this is the expression for the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. To determine the vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, we use the same circuit diagram, and the procedure for finding out the value of BV is, first the coil is adjusted so that its plane is horizontal, and then the coil is adjusted such that it can rotate about a horizontal axis in the magnetic meridian. Next, the coil is rapidly rotated through 180 degrees and the deflection theta in the ballistic galvanometer is observed and noted down. Now, proceeding exactly as in the case of determination of BH, that is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field, we obtain a relation for vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, that is BV. The expression for vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, that is BV is equal to V, is equal to mu naught into NP, where NP is total number of turns of primary coil, into NS, total number of turns of secondary coil, AS, area of secondary coil, into I, upon N into A, into theta V upon theta, Weber per meter square. Let this equation be phi. Now the total intensity of Earth's magnetic field is calculated by the expression under root h square plus v square. By substituting the values of the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field and vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, we have mu naught into np into ns into as into I upon n into a into 1 upon theta into under root theta h square plus theta v square, and this equation be equation number 6. And this equation 6 gives the total intensity of Earth's magnetic field. Now to determine the value of psi, that is angle of depth, the values of BH and BV, that is horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field and vertical component of Earth's magnetic field, is used to calculate the value of psi, that is angle of depth. And it is given by tan psi is equal to V upon H, and this can be obtained by dividing equation 5 by equation 4. That is, tan psi is equal to V upon H, which gives theta V upon theta H, and this is called as psi or angle of depth. And let this equation be 7. To find out the psi value, we need not calibrate the galvanometer, but calibration is required in the case of finding out the value of BH and BV. And the materials or the content of the presentation is taken from the book, that is Electricity and Magnetism, written by Dr. K.K. Tiwari.